Hi, welcome to our Pharma Topics channel, which aims at simplifying the pharmacy subjects and the allied health sciences subjects. Let us see the general principles of chemotherapy. Basically, we will see the terms used. We will see the drug resistance, the mechanism of the action of these drugs or the antibiotics, and we will come across the cross resistance, and we will study about the super infection. So this is the outline of this study. So antibiotic is obtained from another organism which is having an effect on another organism. So let us take this example. The antibiotics is given at different concentration to the medium which contains the bacteria. After 24 hours, if no growth occurs, that medium will be checked, and that determines the minimum inhibitory concentration of these antibiotics or antimicrobials. The lowest concentration of the antimicrobial that inhibits the microbial growth is called the minimum inhibitory concentration. If it is subcultured into next medium and it is incubated for 24 hours, then we can determine the minimum bacterial concentration, which kills 99% of the microbes. The other terminologies used are, in this, if there is no drug, then the bacteria or the microbe multiplies within a short span of time. When a drug is added, the new growth may be affected, and there may be a constant colonial growth maintenance that is called bacteriostatic. If the colonial count reduces gradually, then it is a bactericidal effect. The next terminology is spectrum, or the coverage of the antimicrobial. If it is having a lesser coverage, narrow coverage, then it is called narrow spectrum antibiotic. If it is having a wide coverage, it is called broad spectrum antibiotic. For example, isoniazid is effective against mycoplasma only, then it is a narrow spectrum antibiotic. Tetracyclines are effective against most of the microbes, then it is a broad spectrum antibiotic. The other terms are concentration dependent killing. If the concentration is increased, the bactericidal effect will increase. That is called concentration dependent killing. Example, aminoglycosides and chloroquinolones. Next case is, if the time increases, the killing increases. As if you increase the dose, take another dose in a different time, instead of taking one dose, three or four doses at different spaced time intervals, then it is called time dependent killing. For example, beta lactams and vancomycin exerts time dependent killing effect. The next is, even after the drug reduces below the minimum effective concentration, if it exerts even the antibiotic effect even after that, then that is called post antibiotic effect. That means the drug is stopped, then it is having the therapeutic effect. So example, carbapenems, tetracyclines, chloramphenicol and rifampicin exert this effect. Let us see the site of action of antimicrobials, or the mechanism of action of the antimicrobials. Usually the microbial cell contains, for example, a bacteria contains a cell wall called peptidoglycan layer. And the microbes can synthesize their own DNA from para-aminobenzoic acid, which gets converted to dihydrofolic acid and tetrahydrofolic acid, purines, pyrimidines, and then DNA. Then from the DNA, mRNA gets synthesized, and then from that the proteins are synthesized. The bacterial ribosomal proteins essential for protein synthesis are two subtypes. One is 30S ribosomal subunits and 50S ribosomal subunits. In humans, it is 70S ribosomal subunits. Let us see the drugs. One first category is cell wall synthesis inhibitors. Example, penicillin, cephalosporins, carbapenems, monobactams and glycopeptides. The next is drugs inhibiting intermediary metabolism. For example, sulfonamides and trimethoprim are inhibiting the pathway of PABA or para-aminobenzoic acid. The next is 30S subunit protein synthesis inhibitors. Example, aminoglycosides and tetracyclines. The next is 50S ribosomal subunit protein synthesis inhibitors, macrolides, streptogramins, lincosamides and linezolid. There are DNA gyrase inhibitors targeting the DNA of the microbe, fluoroquinolone, ciprofloxacin, ofloxacin, levofloxacin, like that. Then mRNA synthesis inhibitor is rifampicin. It is an anti-tubercular drug. You can refer a separate video which has been put for anti-TB drugs. So let us see what is a drug resistant. The drug is not efficient for this microbe. Why this occurs? After some period of time, the microbe becomes resistant. At the start, it was responding. Then it got resistance. The first case is the penetration or diffusion of the drug is getting reduced. The microbe may generate an efflux pump. Even when the drug enters into it, it throws it off out of the microbial cell, which it reduces the efficacy or causes a drug resistance. Next is, it may synthesize some enzymes which convert the active drug to inactive principles. It's the alteration in the binding site. If the shape changes, then the binding of the drug may get affected. So let us see some examples. So decreased penetration or increased efflux happens as the resistance for tetracyclines, quinolones, aminoglycosides, imipenem and macrolides. The drug metabolizing enzymes, the classical example is beta-lactamases inhibiting penicillins and cephalosporins, acetyltransferases inhibiting or causing resistance to chloramphenicol and aminoglycosides. Alterations in the binding protein. The altered penicillin binding proteins cause resistance of penicillins in pneumococci. Alterations in the DNA targets happens for fluoroquinolones. And the last one is mutations in the ribosomal subunits. So the protein synthesis is not affected. This is the resistance for aminoglycosides and macrolides. Let us see how the mechanism of how this resistance happens, how this gets transported from one microbe to other microbe. So take an example of one group of bacteria which is susceptible or getting bactericidal or bacteriostatic effect with the antimicrobial. After that, a few population becomes resistant. This resistant microbe may transfer the resistance to the existing susceptible bacteria. That is called vertical transfer. It may transfer the resistant gene to another group of organism for which the drug is not exposed. Then that is the mechanism which transfer the resistance to another group. Then it acquires the gene of the resistant gene that becomes resistant. That may occur through conjugation, which is sexual contact, chloramphenicol resistance in typhoid. Next is transduction. If a bacteria swallows another bacteria, then transduction happens. Example, penicillin and erythromycin. The next is transformation. The resistance occurring through the medium. This is a rare phenomenon. How to reduce this? Then unnecessary use of antimicrobials should not be there. Sensitivity testing is must. Combination therapy can address this issue. For example, in case of TB, HIV, subacute bacterial endocarditis, or intensive or dose increased therapy in for notorious bacteria such as E. coli, TB and tetanus. Let us see what is cross resistance. That means a bacterium gets resistance to a drug for which it is not exposed. That is called cross resistance, because it becomes resistant to one antimicrobial, and that is the reason it is not answering to another group of same class of antimicrobial is called cross resistance. It is occurring between the same family. Complete cross resistance means, for example, if the microbe is resistant to tetracycline, oxytetracycline, it is not answering, it is resistant to total all the other tetracyclines. For example, it is resistant to doxycycline, it becomes resistant to minocycline for which it is not exposed. So that is called complete cross resistance. If that is not the case, the same group of class of drugs are becoming resistant, but not all the drugs, that is called partial resistance. For example, gentamicin offers cross resistance to tobramycin, amikacin, kanamycin, which are all belonging to the same group. The other examples are HIV, lamivudine cross resistant to NRTI emtricitabine, which is belonging to the same class. Zidovudine resistance to stavudine. Then cross resistance of protease inhibitors, that is nelfinavir, indinavir, ritonavir, they all become resistant if one NRTI, one protease inhibitor becomes resistant. The next is cross resistance between HIV integrase inhibitors. Raltegravir, dolutegravir, they have cross resistance. Not only this, even the anti-cancer drugs exhibit the same phenomena. Carboplatin shares the cross resistance with cisplatin. For HIV drugs and the cancer drugs, separate videos has been put. Please refer it. Let us see what is super infection. For infections, we are taking antimicrobials. If you get a new infection out of this, then it is called super infection. It's called drug induced infection. In our GIT, oral tract or genitourinary tract, there are several bacteriums which are living but not harming us. They are called normal flora. The normal flora helps in digestion and it helps in production of some vitamins. It even offers some immunity to us because they are good bacteria, symbiotic in nature. They get nutrition from us and they don't do any disease to us. Take another example. If we get a infectious, we use a term pathogen, that is causing disease to us, then that is not a normal flora. We take antimicrobials to encounter this. So infection with the infectious pathogen. If an antimicrobial is taken for that, you can address this issue. Example, tetracyclines, chloramphenicol and newer cephalosporins, which are broad spectrum. It kills the newer pathogen. At the same time, it can kill the normal flora also, if it is broad spectrum. So several problems arise out of this. We get newer infections, candidiasis, pseudomembranous enterocolitis, proteus infections, and pseudomonas infections. The drugs of choice to address this issue are nystatin for candidiasis, metronidazole is the drug of choice for pseudomembranous enterocolitis, gentamicin is the drug of choice for protease infections, and piperacillin is the drug of choice for pseudomonas super infections. Can we reduce this? Yes, it is possible. Prevention, always it is better to use a narrow spectrum wherever possible. For viral infections, there is no need to take the bacterial antibacterial drugs. So if we go to a retail shop without prescription, this may happen. And unnecessarily taking antibiotics also causes this problem. I hope it is a short information of all the general principles of chemotherapy or the antimicrobial therapy. I hope it will be useful for you. Thank you for listening. Happy learning. Kindly share this to more of your friends. Kindly subscribe to our Pharma Topics channel and encourage us to put more videos for your studies. Thank you.